In this problem, we're asked to integrate the sine function on a symmetric interval from negative pi to pi. And whenever you see a symmetric interval, you should immediately begin thinking about the parity of the function that you're integrating. So that means the evenness or oddness. Well, we know the sine function is an odd function, and I'll post a link to the video where I showed that. And we also know if I integrate an odd function on an interval symmetric about the origin, it's going to vanish. I get zero out of this. So just to illustrate why this is true, I'll pop in a graph of the sine function and shade in the area represented by this integral. All right, there's the graph of the sine function, and the area bounded by the sine function has been shaded in from negative pi to pi. And I can see by symmetry that this definitely comes out to be zero because area under the x-axis counts as negative and area above the x-axis counts as positive. Now, if you insist on using brute force, you could have guessed the antiderivative and evaluated it across the endpoints. So let's just wrap things up by checking out that approach to the problem. The antiderivative of sine is negative cosine, because when I differentiate the cosine, it gives me an additional minus sign. And I'm going to evaluate that from negative pi to pi. And when I plug in the upper limit, I get negative cosine of pi. And then I subtract what I get when I plug in the lower limit. Negative cosine negative pi. There's a lot of minus signs floating around in this. Cosine pi is negative 1. So the first term gives me a positive 1. Then I have a negative negative here, so I'm going to write plus and just cancel those out. And then I have the cosine of negative pi, which is also negative 1. So 1 minus 1, and I get 0 out of it, which I knew was going to happen because of the symmetry of the graph. If you find the math content on Zach's lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.